Hey everyone, Daniel and Sunny here, and welcome to the May Modern Work Update.
As you can see, Daniel and I have had the opportunity to meet up this month. Hi Daniel.
Hi Sunny. As you begin to take advantage of the hybrid workplace, just as we are, it's reassuring to know the tool set that you use to get work done every day effectively, Microsoft Teams, has been evolving as well, with new capabilities to support the new way of working.
In this video, we'll take you through a couple of new features in Microsoft Teams Meetings, including PowerPoint Live and apps in Teams Meetings. If you're interested in these features, check out the webinars our team is running at the end of this month later in this video. Wait, Daniel, you're on mute.
Let's get started with PowerPoint Live. Presenting PowerPoints online has always been a challenge. Whether it's dealing with the fact you can't see your speaker notes, missing out on audience reactions, or in general struggling to move back and forth, and the dreaded next slide please we've all heard way too many times.
PowerPoint Live aims to change this, bringing a cloud-native, low bandwidth experience into your Microsoft Teams meetings. Let's check it out.
Here in my meeting, I'll open the share tray as I would normally, but then, selecting a display, I'll come down and look for a PowerPoint share, and then choose a deck of interest.
Once the slide opens, my view as a presenter is immediately shifted. Not only do I have the notes shown in my display here on the right, I've also got access to all of my slides down here along the bottom.
Don't fear, your audience can't see this. Rather, they only see what's highlighted in red here. However, they do at least initially have the ability to navigate through my content on their own. I can leverage the I option at the top of the display to enable or remove this ability though at any time. Whatever I show as the presenter, however, will be captured in the recording.
I also want to note an additional trick. Firstly, imagine that you're midway through your presentation and you want to jump back to a key title. Well, that's easy by pressing the overview button to all your content, then simply select the one that you're after and it will move it for everyone.
Notice as an audience member, Sunny can also enable accessibility settings on the presentation. And I can do this as a presenter as well. Both high contrast settings and live slide translation to several languages are available. Because the presentation is loaded in the cloud for each user customizes their own perspective.
Now, let's consider handing over the content. We can do this in a really simple way. If Daniel wishes to present next, he can simply press Take Control, an option available to all presenters in your Teams meetings. When Daniel does this, he receives the full presenter experience, and I simply get the audience view.
We've also made it easier to add apps to your Teams meetings, adding additional functionality like surveys and task tracking. Rather than waiting for the call to begin and setting this up in the calendar, we can now add apps directly inside of the Teams meeting, including things like Forms, Asana, and Decisions.
All we need to do is select Add an App from our More Options menu and select one from the list. It's as simple as that. Forms, meeting tracking tools, notes, and more from our fantastic third-party providers are available.
We'd also like to invite you to our upcoming Microsoft Teams webinar, where we go deeper on how you can thrive in your next Teams meeting and showcase some frameworks to guarantee its success.
Check it out at the registration link below, and we'll see you next month. Bye.
Bye.